Human body parts are pretty remarkable, and each and every part of your body is important, right? Turns out there are parts of your body that are actually pretty useless. In fact, science tells us that there are body parts you don't even need. Here's just what you could live without. Of all the useless human body parts, third molars, also known as wisdom teeth, are probably the ones that have caused you the most strife. According to the American Association of Oral and Maxillofacial Surgeons, about 85% of people will need their wisdom teeth removed. In 2007, it was estimated that 5 million wisdom teeth extractions were performed annually in the United States alone.
You're all done. It went great.
Why did I keep my wisdom?
Although wisdom teeth may only seem useful for lining the pockets of oral surgeons and giving us an excuse to eat mashed potatoes for a week, they were once helpful. Robert Coricini, an anthropologist at Southern Illinois University, told New Scientist that wisdom teeth didn't become useless until humans' diets changed to become, quote, softer and more processed. When that happened, our molars were being used less and less, which led to overcrowding in the mouth. Coricini explained, "So the third molars, the last teeth to erupt, run out of space to erupt." Although you are more than likely born with an appendix, you don't need this body part to survive. In fact, 1 in 20 people will experience appendicitis in the United States and will need to undergo surgery to have their appendix completely removed. Despite what you may believe, however, the appendix isn't totally and completely useless. In a news release provided to WebMD, William Parker, assistant professor of experimental surgery at Duke University Medical Center in North Carolina, revealed, "The abundance of circumstantial evidence makes a strong case for the role of the appendix as a place where the good bacteria can live safe and undisturbed until they are needed." Nevertheless, it is thought that the appendix was more useful when humans relied on a more plant-rich diet. Dorsa Amir, an evolutionary anthropologist at Boston College, told Business Insider, "As we started switching to a more diverse diet and targeting meat, we didn't need super long and complicated intestinal tracts anymore." Although you can likely name the major organs in your body, you probably don't realize that you have a little human body part called vomeronasal organ, or the VNO. According to New Scientist, this organ, quote, consists of a pair of structures that nestle in the nasal lining or the roof of the mouth. If you didn't know you had it, it's okay. It doesn't do anything for you anyway. In rodents and some other mammals, the VNO serves to detect pheromones. While most adult humans have a VNO of sorts, it doesn't work in the same way. Well, it actually doesn't really work at all. Michael Meredith, a neuroscientist at Florida State University, explained, "If you look at the anatomy of the structure, you don't see any cells that look like the sensory cells in other mammalian VNOs. You don't see any nerve fibers connecting the organ to the brain. Essentially, the organ is there, but it's not hooked up to anything." Ready for an experiment? While resting the back of your wrist and forearm against a table, squeeze the tips of your fingertips together and flex your wrist. Do you see a muscle appear in the center of your wrist? Don't freak out if you don't. Around 10% of the human population do not have this muscle called the palmaris longus, as noted by Encyclopedia Britannica. While that means most of us do indeed have the muscle, not one of us needs this human body part. Well, unless you want to be really great at climbing trees. While some believe it helped humans to grip and climb, a person's grip strength does not depend on whether they have the palmaris longus muscle or not. This muscle is actually most useful when it's taken from the arm and used elsewhere. According to the Encyclopedia Britannica, today the palmaris longus is commonly harvested as a source of tissue for tendon grafting and reconstructive surgery. If you don't have a tail, do you really need a tailbone? Although most people aren't born with tails, you did actually have one in the womb. Encyclopedia Britannica explains, "In the 6th week of gestation, the human embryo possesses a tail, complete with several vertebrae. In the next couple weeks of development, however, the tail disappears, and over time, the vertebrae fuse to form the coccyx, or tailbone, in the adult."
Oh my God!
Despite losing the tail in development, what's left of the human body part can still be useful. According to spinehealth.com, the tailbone helps a person remain balanced and stable while sitting down. It's also where many of the pelvic floor muscles connect. Although the coccyx definitely sounds helpful, science categorizes it as rudimentary. As spinehealth.com explained, it is, quote, no longer necessary in the human body. We're all thinking it, right? Men's nipples are pointless, so what's the deal with these human body parts? Tara Bacon, a family physician based in Texas, told Cosmopolitan that both men and women develop nipples at the same time in the womb, before there's any differentiation of sex. Ian Tattersall, a paleoanthropologist at the American Museum of Natural History in New York City, laid down the details while speaking with Live Science. Basically, males and females are all built from the same genetic blueprint. Then they develop in slightly different directions in utero, and particularly after we hit puberty. Tattersall says that because the nipples have already developed and, quote, there's no real metabolic cost to having nipples, there's no compelling reason for the male body to ditch their vestigial nips. Tattersall continued saying, natural selection is not hovering there all of the time to get rid of things we absolutely don't need. And thus, male nipples persist. When you're cold, scared, or even nostalgic, you may find your skin covered in goosebumps. Muscle fibers called erector pili, which are influenced by adrenaline, cause this to happen. And humans aren't the only ones who go through this. If you've ever seen your dog or cat's fur stand upright when it spots something it deems threatening, their erector pili are at work. George A. Bubenik, a physiologist and professor of zoology at the University of Guelph in Ontario, explained in an article for Scientific American. These bumps are caused by a contraction of miniature muscles that are attached to each hair. Each contracting muscle creates a shallow depression on the skin's surface, which causes the surrounding area to protrude. In animals, that process can help retain heat and make an animal appear larger and thus more threatening, but Bubenik says that in people, the reaction is, quote, useless because we do not have a hair coat, according to Bubenik. Despite not serving much of a purpose at all, we continue to get goosebumps.
Oh. I'm getting creative goosebumps here.
After the upteenth time of shaving your armpits, you've gotta wonder why we even have hair there to begin with. The leading theory has to do with attracting a mate. Shawnee Francis, board-certified dermatologist and clinical assistant professor at the University of Chicago Pritzker School of Medicine, told Health, different people make different odors, and believe it or not, odor is an attraction to the opposite sex. It's nasty, but it's cool. Of course, you may not be all that concerned with attracting a mate and don't want to waft your armpits around to attract attention. While armpit hair is no longer a necessity, it's not likely to go away anytime soon, Francis explained. Assuming that there is an evolutionary advantage of attracting a genetically compatible mate, then underarm hair is likely to remain. Whether you choose to remove or embrace it, though, is entirely up to you. In decades past, having your tonsils removed was more like a rite of passage than it was a surgical operation. Since the 70s, though, the number of tonsillectomies performed in the United States has declined in recent years. Tonsils are part of the lymphatic system and do serve a purpose in fighting off infection. Daniel Lieberman, professor of human evolutionary biology at Harvard University, told Men's Health, "Your oral cavity is an entryway to your body, so immune cells in your throat can help you fight respiratory infections. However, frequent infections can cause these human body parts to become enlarged and can affect a person's breathing. In these cases, a tonsillectomy is still advised. Healthy tonsils are, of course, useful. After all, they're lymph nodes. That said, they're not your only lymph nodes. It's because of this that it's possible to live a healthy life without them." If you've ever caught a glimpse of your dog or cat's third eyelid, it's a creepy sight. When a dog's third eyelid, or nictitating membrane, closes across his eye, it looks like his eye is rolling back in his head. Deborah S. Friedman, veterinarian and diplomate with the American College of Veterinary Ophthalmologists, explained that a nictitating membrane is like a windshield washer for the cornea, clearing debris and mucus. A third of a dog's tears are also produced by it, and the third eyelid as a whole can protect the dog's cornea from injury. In addition to dogs, other mammals, reptiles, and birds have third eyelids. You may be surprised to learn that you too have a third eyelid of sorts. However, this human body part is movable and only covers the inside corners of the eyes, rendering it pretty useless. During the 6th week of gestation, tissue begins to form the ear canal and eventually the outer ear. In some people, a human body part called a tubercle, aka Darwin's point or Darwin's tubercle, begins to form. Technically a malformation, it resembles a bump on the rim of the outer ear. A Darwin's point is completely benign, and while it can be surgically removed, there's no medical reason for doing so. Anthony Scalfani, a surgeon at the New York Eye and Ear Infirmary, explained to New Scientist that the malformation is genetic. Because a person only needs to inherit one of the genes for Darwin's point to develop, it's assumed that may have had a purpose at some point. A Darwin's point may be useless these days, but some people still have them. According to a 2016 study, a Darwin's point has been found in high percentages of Spanish, Indian, and Swedish populations. You may have even noticed that Scarlett Johansson appears to have this unique congenital anomaly. Can you wiggle your ears? If you can, that's thanks to your auricular muscles, the muscles of your outer ear. Even if you can't, though, you still have these human body parts. Compared to other mammals and the few of you ear wigglers out there, our ears are pretty one-dimensional. While some mammals are able to locate sounds and decipher emotion with their ears, we, merely hear sounds with our ears. Okay, that is a bit of an oversimplification. Our ears can analyze sounds while also controlling our equilibrium and coordination. There's no arguing that ears are useful and beneficial parts of the human body. Nevertheless, our outer ear muscles have been rendered essentially useless. Because these muscles don't help us to pinpoint sounds like they do for other mammals, it is thought that humans turn their heads to compensate for our non-functioning auricular muscles. According to Stephen Hackley, a psychologist at the University of Missouri, the muscle still isn't strong enough to physically move the ear, even if you can get a little wiggle out of it. Ear wiggling, it seems, is nothing but a party trick.
Ready?
Wow.
Check out one of our newest videos right here. Plus, even more list videos about your favorite stuff are coming soon. Subscribe to our YouTube channel and hit the bell so you don't miss a single one.